Chronic cough in children. See, I'll make this video in English. Just for style, I'll put the stethoscope. It add value. Now, chronic cough in children is very, 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 very common. We are seeing children coughing for 14 days, 20 days, 1 month, 2 month. See, it's a huge burden not only on the family but also on the society. Now, how will you assess the situation? It ranges from allergy causing post-nasal irritation of throat, that you do a bulgum, the phlegm falling into the throat and causing irritation. From that to allergy, asthma, hyperreactive airway, irritation of upper airway, irritation of lower airway, frequent wet cough, it's a very, very significant irritating disease. It could be TB, it could be allergy, it could be enlarged nursing. So these things you need to be really careful. Suppose if the cough is in the early morning, it could be a dry cough of asthma, or it could be a wet cough due to hyperreactive. Asthma can also have wet cough, but more of the bigger children, asthma will be respiratory distress and with dry cough. And asthma can even worsen at night or even soon after exercise. In small children, after feed, when they lie down, if they get recurrent cough, it might be due to the spitups. You can search YouTube for my video on spitups. That will give you a detailed explanation. Now we are dealing with chronic cough, though I am not going to explain about spitups. Now, what about suppose a sudden onset of cough? It might be due to while eating peanuts or some chips or kurkure. It might be due to a foreign body which accidentally has gone inside. And thereafter, the child is having persistent coughs. You need to suspect a foreign body. Sometimes children get a habit of cough. They have listened to elders doing and child or the chatter. So I have seen many children who are having this habit cough. It is rare in my clinic because we focus on the habits of children and how to mentally strengthen the children in my clinic. So it's kind of a cough in which child suddenly has this kind of cough. Then suddenly when child sees me, so this kind of cough. So sometimes during this season of April, May, the pollens are running around and they still have this allergic rhinitis and thereafter the cough. So there are very many varieties of cough. So whatever the assessment it is, the intricate thing is, if there is nothing foreign inside, then most of them has a baseline low immunity. Chronic cough mostly is due to a baseline low immunity, thereby leading to allergy or infection or enlarged lymph nodes. These are all has to do with baseline low immunity. And overall, the body which has a baseline low immunity has a composition not correctly made. It might be due to excess of animal milk and products, excess of non-vegetarian diet, pro-inflammatory diet. The pro-inflammatory diet is excess of carbohydrates, excess of saturated fatty acids. Some of them might be from animal milk and products, but lack of essential fatty acids. Essential fatty acids are mostly from flax seeds, nuts, and these nuts are important to create a lungs which is made up of stronger fatty acids. So when you have this less amount of essential fatty acids in the body, your cell membrane is weak and you will break. The same thing is also applicable even for corona also. If you are having low essential fatty acid, you will die. So this can be associated with decreased lung function, which findings of clubbing. Your nails will be like a parrot beak. So this is indication of chronic cough. So sometimes asthma people can have chest pain. Sometimes asthma can even have clubbing. But asthma with clubbing, you need to rule out underlying other diseases also. And this also indicates that clubbing, asthma has been there for a longer period of time. Immunodeficiency can lead to infections. So this immunity need to be boosted. So how did I prevent this chronic cough. See, chronic cough hyperreacted, I prevented by exclusive breastfeeding. First thing I did is, if the mother need to breastfeed, the mother need to have increased amount of breast milk. So you can watch my videos on breast milk, so you can increase it like that. So thereby I have stopped all the artificial formula feed. So artificial formula feed act as a trigger to land the baby up later on in life into chronic cough. So that I have done. Another thing I did is indoor air quality. I have advised whichever babies who have been coughing, the parents need to maintain an indoor air quality. You can use indoor air purifying plants. That is, money plant is one thing you can cultivate easily and use it indoor. And another thing is only wet mopping, no brooming. Avoid soft toys. Avoid upholstery. If you have an upholstery sofa, try to wet mop it often also. That is indoor air quality. Now, body composition, what I advise is 25% carbohydrate, 25% dal product, 25% cereals, which is called carbohydrate, quality carbohydrate. Cereals include, I tell them, millets, whole wheat, brown rice. Millets are much, much more powerful than wheat and rice. And this will balance the body to an anti-allergic state. And 25% dal product, variety of dal and sprouts. You can sprout the dal and use it. And 25% you need to use fruits and 25% vegetables other than potato. Potato is not a vegetable. So you can balance the body to strengthen it so that if there is some infection or something, the body won't crack. If there won't be allergic tendency. This is widely called as anti-allergic diet or anti-allergic food. You can easily search in YouTube and you can get it. And another thing I have done is avoiding of milk and milk product. Milk product, bakery, preserved food items and non-veg, these are notoriously pro-inflammatory, point number one. Second point is notoriously allergic also. And three, it changes the microbiota of the body. Microbiota of the body, when it changes, your microbiome change, your genetic material and composition change, and you will be in a situation in which you will be easily triggered into allergy. That is, creating a body out of petrol can get you to be inflamed. If you build something out of petrol, a small fire is enough to light the fire. Small spark will light the fire. So if you create a body of wrong building material, then definitely there will be problem. In bigger children, there will be sinusitis. Thus, drip will come to the throat and cause chronic cough. The most common in small children we see is allergy cough, which could be hyperreactive airway disease. So these are the points you need to remember. I have a detailed video of hyperreactive airway, which you can see. So I will summarize today's video. Whatever be the reason of chronic cough, I have avoided allergy, asthma and nebulizer. And I have also mentioned an early identification of allergy video that you can see. In my immune system balancing video, I have mentioned it. Okay? So early identification of allergy, like early the child might have rubbing of eyes, irritation of nose, skin allergy, early identification, exclusive breastfeeding, avoiding allergens by the mother and baby, just avoiding pro-inflammatory foods, like regulating the amount of carbohydrate, high quality essential fatty acids, high quality dal product, vegetables other than potato, and lot of fruits. Fruits we have nothing to do. People tell banana causes cough. No, nothing like that. And boosting the immunity by using herbs. So this is how I easily avoided allergy and asthma. And what all videos you need to see? You need to see my atopic dermatitis video. You need to see my hyperreactive airway video. You need to see my immune balancing video. And also for small children, if they have cough after they breastfeed, it might be due to Spitups. You can see my Spitups videos. These are available freely in YouTube. And thus you can easily avoid this nebulizer, this bulgum and everything. And you need to improve the indoor air quality also by avoiding the certain items I have mentioned. This is so simple. And you can easily prevent chronic cough. But you need to rule out tuberculosis, which can only be treated by infection. you need to rule out sinusitis and other infections also if there is locally available. And if the child has developed a sudden cough, you need to rule out inhalation of foreign body. Foreign body might be some peanut or something that might have gone inside the lungs. So this is how I have avoided allergy and asthma. And once you get this allergy and asthma, what I do is I have a lot of herbs, I have a lot of anti-inflammatory medicines, anti-allergic medicines, lot of probiotics, lot of balancing, lot of counseling, and we do test for allergies and we'll find out the level of allergies and other things, and we can easily help you and we can give you time by immunity boosting, and might even, I have almost 99.9% avoided even inhalers. That is the power of your own body. Your body has enough power to cure any disease you have. That much powerful the body is. That's how I have helped my parents to cure the disease by themselves and reduce the workload on me. I hope you will share this video. You can take care, follow this and post your comment on how this have helped you. You might follow this for about 6 weeks and thereafter later on come back and save this video and come back and comment and how it have helped you. Take care. Have a good day.